بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today inshallah we will speak about the etiquettes of adab of يوم العيد, the day of عيد. First of all, we know that it is the festival of the Muslim. It is the festival or the day in which we celebrate the Eid or the breaking of the fast. So it is called Eid al-Fitr. So we're going to speak about the etiquettes of Eid al-Fitr. First and foremost is before we go for Salat al-Eid, it is mustahab to go and perform ghusl, a ritual bath, clean yourself, make yourself clean and pure before you head towards the Salat al-Eid. This is the first thing that we do on the day of Eid. We can make a ghusl after Salat al-Fajr or before Salat al-Fajr. It is okay, inshallah, that this is one of the preparation of Salat al-Eid, is that we perform ghusl. Number two, since it is the Eid al-Fitr, it is the celebration of breaking the fast, it is sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to break the fast before going to Salat al-Eid. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he would eat odd numbers of dates, 1, 3, 5 number of dates, in order to show that this day it is not allowed to fast. So in the morning we wake up, we make the ghusl, we have the date, a cup of water. If ever you don't have dates, you can have whatever. Break your fast before you go for Salat al-Eid. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَلِتُكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةِ وَلِتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking about the Eid, is that whenever you have finished the prescribed month and then you start glorifying Allah Azza wa Jal, وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهِ, you start praising Allah, glorifying Allah Azza wa Jal by saying the takbirat. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sahaba, from their practice, they would say the takbirat from the morning until the Imam would come out. So the third etiquette of Eid is that once we set out to go to the Musalla or to the masjid to go pray Salat al-Eid, we say the takbir, which is Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. So this is the way that we may do the takbirat, and there are different ways mentioned in the ahadith as well. And where do we pray the Salat al-Eid? It is preferable to pray in a musanna, in an open places. This is the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But if these places are not found, then there is no problem in you praying in the masjid. But praying in the musanna or in the idgah, the people call it in some language, or in an open area, this is the sunnah way of praying Salat al-Eid. And who should go for Salat al-Eid? Everyone can go Salat al-Eid. Male, female, old, young, even the ladies who are on their menses, they're not supposed to pray. Even they, at the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they were asked to go and listen to the khutbah and attend that gathering on Eid day. As well as the way of Salat al-Eid, how is it made? The way of Salat al-Eid, how it is made, is different from Salat al-Jum'ah. Salat al-Jum'ah, we do the khutbah first and then we do the Salah. But for Salat al-Eid, we do the Salah first and then we do the khutbah. And the Salah differs. In the first raka'ah, we do 7 takbirat and then we read Surah Fatiha and then a Surah. And then when we get up for the second raka'ah, We do 5 takbirat and then we start the Surah Fatiha and other Surah. So this is a matter of following the Imam in which you're going to pray inshallah on Eid al-Fitr. So these are the etiquettes of Salat al-Eid. As well as wearing beautiful clothes, adorning yourself. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya Bani Adam, خُذُوا زِينَتَكُمْ عِنْدَ كُلِّ مَسْجِدْ. Oh, the son of Adam, take your beauty to the masjid, especially on the day of Eid. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would wear a special cloak on the two Eid, which means that he had a special clothes in order to pray Salatul Eid, which means that it is something special. He would wear something beautiful to go to the masjid, not for the male. As for the female, if they're going for the musalla or the masjid to pray Salatul Eid, they should go in their Muslim, in their perfect shari'i attire. They go and they come back, and then once they come back, they can show their beauty to their mahram. This is okay. As well as offering congratulations. How do we offer congratulations on the day of Eid? We don't have anything like how the Prophet Muhammad did, what he used to say, but the Sahaba, the companions of the Prophet, they used to say the word تقبل الله منا ومنكم, which means may Allah Azza wa Jalla accept from us and from you. This is how they used to greet others on Yawmul Eid. And there's no problem, the ulama says, if ever you want to greet them in a manner that's not against Sharia, like Eid Mubarak, this is okay, or kul am antum bi khair, some people they may say that it is okay, but it is better to start with what the Sahaba was doing, which is taqabbal Allahu minna wa minkum. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would go to the masjid or musalla on the day of Eid. He would go in a route and he would come back with a different route. So if ever we are able to do that, we go to the musalla with one route or one way, and then on the way back we take another way. Why? The reason behind that is because on Yawmul Qiyamah, whatever we do in regards to ibadah, they're going to talk for us. They're going to be witnessed for us or against us on Yawmul Qiyamah. So we're walking in one way, come back in a different direction. You know, it is kind of witnessing a lot of steps for us. As well as showing the people around, the number of Muslims that are there in that community, as well as you get to meet a lot of people. When you go in one way, you come back in a different way, it shows that you're meeting different people, you're congratulating different people. So, and as well as this day, it is haram for you to fast. On Eid day, you are not supposed to fast, as it is a day of eating and drinking, like how the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said. So these are the main etiquettes that we as Muslims, we should adhere in order to be upon the steps of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Let's have the Eid just like how the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam has taught us. Maybe we haven't done them before, now we want to do it in that way. And make sure that we do not fall into haram on that day. That doesn't mean that Ramadan is over and now we can fall into haram. The hijab that we used to wear, leave it on. The beard that we have, leave it on. The haram that we were not doing, just let that be away. Don't indulge haram gathering, haram thing on the day of Eid, thinking that it is okay. No, our salah carries on. Our siyam goes on as nawafil, in order for us to be upon an istiqamah. Inshallah, we speak about an istiqamah later on. Hada wallahu ta'ala a'lam wa jazakum allahu khaira. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.